Good morning, student. I Purnima welcome you to my class. And children, we are doing the same lesson once again. We are going to do the same lesson which we were doing yesterday. That is Children at Work. It is written by children Geeta Wolf, Anushka Ravishankar, and RJ Sen. Three people are there behind writing this lesson. So, children, before starting the lesson, let me tell you important background, important points of the lesson. That children are made to work and earn in different ways. Some of them help their family make a livelihood. Many run away from unhappy homes and they need to support themselves. They don't go to any school. Velu was an 11-year-old boy. He ran away from home. He was wandering around for hours before getting on a train to Chennai without a ticket. So he was a boy who ran from his home, and children from the village, he wanted to go to town so that he was having this faith that he would earn anything for his livelihood. The Kanyakumari Express pulled in at Chennai station. Now, children, when he reached at Chennai station, Kanyakumari Express, it was standing there. Velu got down and sat on a bench. Velu went there and sat on a bench. He ran to Chennai on a train to Chennai without a ticket in a Kanyakumari express. The Kanyakumari express pulled in at Chennai station. Velu got down and sat on a bench. He had never before seen so many people with their luggage. The noise was terrible. He was feeling tired, miserable and hungry. In his bundle, he carried a shirt, a towel and a comb. He had neither money nor ticket. He tried to sleep on the floor near the door. He heard the rough voice of a girl around his own age. The girl was carrying a big bag. She was picking up plastic cups and putting them into the sack. Her name was Jaya. She sat down next to him. She said she could find some food for him to eat. She stood up to go. Velu had nowhere else to go, so he followed her. He ran after her. The two got to the road. Smoke and dust made Velu's head spin. The girl dragged him to the other side of the street. She took him on a bridge. Velu peeped over the railing. The road under him ran to the city. Velu saw big buildings in the distance. Jaya warned him not to get caught, otherwise he would be in jail. His bare feet burned on the hot tar road as he walked. They finally stopped in front of a big building. A marriage was going to be performed inside. Behind the hall was a garbage heap. The girl picked up a crushed banana and a vada, which Velu ate unwillingly. He never thought in a dream that he would be eating such type of food. Jaya, so children, he ate vada and crushed banana, which was thrown by the people in a marriage ceremony. He ate it. He felt better. Then the girl went to home to drop her full bag and get another one. Velu also joined her. Jay and Velu walked along the road and came to a bridge across a dirty drain. They came to a row of huts built out of wood, plastics and sheet. It was Jaya village. She dumped her sack there and gave him a pair of old shoes, a sack and a stick. He wondered what work she wanted him to do. She told him that they were big rag pickers. So what work she was doing, children? She was doing the work of a rag pickers. They collected things from rubbish, bin, paper, plastic and glass. It was sold to Jaggu, a junk dealer. Velu had no option. He decided to work as a rag picker until he found a better job. So children, we were there at page number 10. I have discussed all the important point of the lesson. Okay, so it was Velu follows his friend through the crowded street to a big building. Behind the building, there is a big garbage bin. Velu wonder why they are there at all. He caught up with the girl as she was leaving the station. When they got to the road, Velu found that the vehicles kept coming up and never stopped for anyone. So now, children, from the station, he was going to the road. and lot of traffic was there which Velu hadn't he did not see it earlier. So smoke and dust flew at him from all sides. Now children, he came from the population free area and he saw a lot of smoke and dust flew at him from all sides, making his head spin. Now children, head spins means he was feeling dizzy. They had to wait for a long time before they could find a gap to run through. Velu kept hesitating and girl finally dragged him to the other side. Now then, when traffic was there, that girl, she was used to it. There was a gap behind the vehicle, she passed it through those gap to the other side of the Renu. But Velu, he was helpless because he had never met such a type of situation earlier. So simply he was hesitating whether he should go between the gaps or not. But the girl finally dragged him to the other side and she told him, "What do you think you are doing? Grazing cows? If you stand around in the middle of the road like that, you will be chutneying." Chutneying means here, it is not a chutney of pickles, of tomato or a green raw mango. It chutney here means to be killed. So she is telling, if you will stand here in this traffic, you will be killed. Venu's heart was still beating fast. Since children, Venu never saw such type of situation. So his heart was still beating fast. He looked back at central station and the traffic is speeding by. Now children, he looked at the central station and then finally, once again, he looked at the traffic. How had they managed to come through that? They walked along the side of the road under some huge signboard. So children, they walked along the side of the road under the huge signboard. Now page number 11. The girl, Velu looked up at the pictures, banyans, car tires, pen, a woman holding a box. So he looked at the picture. Okay, banyans, car tires, pens, a woman holding a box. The writing was all in English, so he did not know what it means. So children, everything was written in English. So he could not see that what it meant. The girl turned onto a wide bridge and walked up. Now children, the girl, she turned onto a wide bridge and she walked on. Velu stopped and peeped over the railing. Under him, the road ran into the city. In the distance, he could see huge buildings and towers and more road. Now children, Velu stopped and peeped over the railing. What did he saw? Under him, he saw the roads were running into the city. In the distance, he could see huge means vast, big building and towers. And there were so many roads. See that building with the wall around it? If you are not careful, you will soon be counting bars there. The girl grinned and pointed at a huge building. Velu squinted. Velu squinted and read the Tamil sign Central Train. Now children, the girl told that, can you see that building which is there with the wall around it? If you are not careful, you will soon be counting bars there. The girl grinned and pointed at a huge building. Velu squinted and read the Tamil sign. It was written there, Central Jail. "Why? I haven't done anything wrong." "You don't have to do anything. Just don't get caught, that's all." Now he told ki, "Why I should go there? I did not do anything wrong." But the girl told ki, "I know you did not do anything wrong. But if you will just roam here like that, I am sitting idle without doing any work, and if somebody will report about you, you will get caught. So definitely you will go in that building only." "What does she mean?" Velu wonder. Meanwhile, the girl was already heading down the bridge with the sack on her shoulder. So children, Velu saw that the girl was heading down. The girl was already heading down the bridge with a sack on her shoulder. What was in it? He had seen her putting plastic cups into it at the station. Now again, children, the girl was already heading down the bridge with a sack on her shoulder. Now what was in it? Now Venu remembered that he saw her putting plastic cups into it at the station. "What are you carrying in that bag?" "Things, bottles, paper." Now Venu asked what she was carrying in that. So he is telling ki, "I'm carrying so many things like bottles, am carrying bottle, okay, things and paper. Velu wondered what she was doing with them, but he felt shy to ask any more question. Velu wondered what she was doing with them, but he felt shy to ask any more question. It was, so he wanted to ask that what she will do with that, but he felt shy and he could not ask any further question. It was still morning, but the sun blasted down on the tar. Children, it was morning. Tar is a thick, black, sticky liquid, and blasted down is melt. The sun, children, it was so heat that the sun was blasting down, that is, was melting down on the tar. And Velu bare feet burned. Velu was a poor boy without a slipper, and there in the village he used to walk on the soil, so his feet never burned, but here on the tar his bare feet burned. It was not like walking on a mud road. He was soaked with sweat. Now children, his whole body was soaked with sweat. He tried hard to walk in the shade and keep up with the girl at the same time. She walked really fast. How far away was the food? Now children, she was walking very fast, and Velu was wondering that from where he would get food. After almost an hour of walking, they stopped in front of a big building. So children, after an hour walk, they stopped in front of the big building. Sri Raja Rajeshwari Prasanna Kalyana Mandapam. So it was there, written there, Sri Raja Rajeshwari Prasanna Kalyana Mandapam, read Velu slowly. A sign with letters made of flowers said, Groom J. V. Vinayagan and Bride Rani. So children, with flowers, the name of the groom was written and the name was bride was written. Velu stared at the big cars parked outside. Velu stared at the big car which was parked outside. One of the cars had a flower garden and roses tapped into it. The girl looked around, pulled one off quickly and stuck it in her hair. Come on, she said. Are we going to eat there? Velu asked, looking at the huge hall and the people inside. Page number 12, children. Hopes. Now the girl said, I hope so. Said the girl, shaking her thumb under her nose. She led him behind the hall. Now children, she took him behind the hall. There was a big garbage bin overflowing with rubbish. Rubbish is trash. What is the meaning of rubbish? Trash. There was a big garbage. She led him behind the hall. There was a big garbage bin overflowing with rubbish. So rubbish was a trash. Two goats were standing on the pile. Pile means heap of the garbage. So pile means heap. Heap of what? Heap of garbage. So two goats were standing on the pile, fighting for a banana leaf. So those two goats, they were fighting for a banana leaf. A cloud of flies buzzed around their legs. And children, so many flies were there. They were making a buzzing noise near the leg of the goat. There was a rotten smell in the air. Rotten means dirty smell of garbage. So there was a rotten smell was coming in the air of the garbage. The girl picked up a squashy banana. The squashy is crushed. So the girl, the squashy is crushed. So children, what did the girl do? She picked up a squashy crushed banana and held it out to Velu. Here's a food. And she gave that food to Velu and she told him, she held out her hand to Velu and she told him, here is your food. Velu was shocked. Are we going to eat their leftover? children, he was so shocked that he told that, are we going to eat the leftover? Leftover means discarded. Okay, the food which were left over, he was surprised because till now he hadn't eat anything which was left over. Che, what do you think? I am a dog. I only take untouched food. Here's some more catch. She threw him a vada. Velu looked at it with distaste. Now she is telling, am I a dog or I only take untouched food? And here is some more catch. Now she threw him some vada. Velu looked at it with distaste. Now Velu don't feel like eating it, but he was so hungry that he had to eat it. Otherwise, there was no option for him. Come on, hero. Eat it. You think I like it? I told you I will find you something to eat. Now, the girl, she told him, you are a hero, but you have to eat this, whether you like it or not. And since I promised you, you are new to the city, I promise you that I will provide you the food and I have given you some food. Now, it depends upon you whether you should eat this type of food or not. You would better, don't think I have money to buy food for you. She is telling, don't think I have money to buy food for you. You would better eat what you get until you have your own money. So he is telling, if you want to children eat untouched food, so it's better you should earn your own money and then from that money you can eat it. Velu hesitated, but his stomach squeezed him again. Now children, Velu was very much irritated, hesitated, but his stomach squeezed. Squeezed means twisted. So children, what is the meaning of squeezed? Squeeze means twisted. He gulped down the banana and vada. Gulped down, quickly he swallowed the banana and the vada. His stomach felt better immediately. Now children, he was already suffering from the children hunger. So children, he was suffering from hunger. He could not stop. He ate those things. He knew that if he will not eat, he will not get a food. As his stomach was squeezed or twisted, so he ate those food. His stomach left. His stomach felt better. He could have eaten at least 10 times more. Now children, the food was not there. I was so hungry that he could have eaten 10 times more. But the girl could find only one more banana which she ate herself. Now children, the girl was so generous. She found at least one more banana and she ate herself. Now children, you can see how generous was the girl. How helping attitude she was having. She could eat those food first, but she offered whatever she was having to Velu. Vada and banana. Then she took the food for herself and then she ate it. Now page number 13. So children, you see how tough life was there in the city. It's too early. They have only eaten tiffin. If you are still hungry, you will have to wait for them to finish lunch. Now she is telling ki we have come a bit early. Just now they had only breakfast, they have eaten tiffin. And if you are still hungry, then you will have to wait for them to finish lunch. And whatever will be thrown in the garbage, that we will eat. You can wait if you want. I have to work, I am going. Now she told, this is all I can offer you. I have got a lot of work, I am going. She picked up a couple of bottles from the heap and threw it into her sack. And then children, she walked off. Velu panicked. Now children, Velu was hungry, but he was panicked. Panic means he was afraid. So, children. villain Venu was afraid. He realized that if the girl left him, he had no idea where he was and what to do. Now, children, first of all, he was not having any idea. If the girl will left him there, he is not even aware that where he was and where he would go and how he would go. So it was better to stick to her. Stick to her, that means to be with her. She seemed to know her way around. He ran after her again. Now this girl, she seemed to know the way. So Venu, children, he thought it is intelligent, it is a wise decision to run with her. He called her. He did not even know the girl's name. Now children, it was very surprisingly that he till now he was not knowing the girl's name who had helped him. What is your name? He asked, hurrying behind her. She stopped and turned around. Oh, so you have been following me around without even knowing my name? Jaya. So she told me, till now you were following me without knowing my name. My name is Jaya. I'm not following you. What then? Who got you food? Now she was a good girl. She told me, if you were not following me, then how did you got the food? Who had offered you the food? What then? Can I come with you? Where are you going now? He told, can I come with you? Where are you going? Come if you want. This bag is full. I have to go home to get another one. Now she told, okay, my bag is full now and I am going to home to get some another bag. So children, so what she told him, she told ki this is my bag, I have to go home to get another one. Now children, I will be discussing the question answer of page 16, no, of page 13. So can Velu read Tamil and English? How do you know? Velu could not read signboards in English, but he could read Tamil, as he could read what was written sign on the central jail. If you're not careful, you will soon be counting bars there, the girl said. What is she referring to? She is referring to central jail. What does she mean when she says if you're not careful? She pointed out to Velu that doing wrong was not so important as escaping the police or getting caught. That means if somebody will catch you, definitely you will reach to central jail. Third question, part one, where did the girl lead Velu to? The girl led Velu to a marriage hall. Question number three, second part. What is the question here? What did they get to eat? They got some food from the garbage bin. It was leftover food, crushed banana and a piece of vada. Velu ate, and that girl, she could get only one banana. What work did she do? That the girl, she was a rag picker. She used to rag pick the waste thing and she used to sell. So children, that's all. Comprehension, now we are here in page number 13, part 3rd. There is a row of huts near some dirty puddles. Puddles is muddy pit. Puddle is dirty, muddy pits. So outside one of the hut, Jaya dumps her sack. So dump means she keeps. So outside she keep the sack, Jaya. She keeps the sack outside. And children, grateful to his friend, Velu thinks of the days ahead. Now Velu is very much grateful to her to his friend Jaya. And he is thinking the days ahead. Okay, days ahead, that means future. Okay, that means what will be happening to him after this. Jaya and Velu walked along the roads for half an hour until they came to a bridge across a dirty trickle of water. What is the meaning of trickle? Narrow stream. Trickle means narrow stream. we are in triplicate now. Okay, so she is telling we are in a now triplicate. Now see, that is Buckingham Canal, said Jaya. So children, it was a funny thing. She is comparing the streets of London with her poor place where she was leaving Balustrade. This was a canal near some puddles of water. Was a row of the strangest husks he had ever seen. Now children, Velu hadn't seen such type of huts. Okay, it was some puddle of water. Was a row of the strangest huts he had ever seen. They were built out of all sorts of things: metal, sheets, tires, bricks, wood and plastic. Now children, these huts, they were built of all types of things. It was built of metal sheet, tire, bricks, wood and plastic. Is this where you live? These houses are strange. Now Velu asked you, this is the place where you live? This is full of strange thing. In our village, the houses are made of mud and palm leaf. Now he is telling, in our village, the houses is made of mud and palm leaf. Jaya went around to one of the huts and dumped her sack outside. Then she picked up an empty one. Now children, Jaya went around to one of the huts and dumped her sack outside. Then she picked up an empty one. Let's go. She turned to Velu and gave him a shove. At least help me now. Here, wear these and come with me. And children, at least help me now. Here, wear these and come with me. She threw him a pair of old shoes without a laces and pushed a sack and a stick into his hand. Now she gave him an old pair of shoes. Without laces, she pushed a sack and a stick into his hand. Velu was confused. What work did she want him to do with this thing? The only work he had ever done was on the land on a farm, weeding and taking cows out to graze. Now children, Velu was surprised. He was not aware that what type of work she wanted to take from him, because till now he had only worked in a land on a farm, weeding. And weeding is pulling unwanted plants and taking cows out to graze. Are there any farms in the city? He asked Jaya. She laughed and thumped a stick on the ground. Farms? There are no farms here. We are rag pickers. Children, who are rag pickers? Rag pickers who pick up the garbages. So she told that there is no farm here. And we are the rag pickers. See my sack full of things I collected. Collected from where? Asked Velu. From rubbish bin. Where else? Now she told Velu, you can see the things which I have collected from the rubbish bin. You collect rubbish? Velu had never heard of such a thing. Now children, Velu was surprised. He thought, do you collect rubbish? I, blockhead. Now she teased him by saying blockhead. It is not any rubbish, only paper, plastic, glass, such things. So he's telling, actually, if you will, in my words, it is not a rubbish. It is paper, glass, plastics, okay, such thing. And we sell it to Zam Bazar Jaggu. And a person is named Jaggu. We all go to him and sell all this thing. Velu was puzzled. He had heard of people throwing away rubbish, but why would anyone want to buy rubbish? Now Velu was confused, because till now he had seen people throwing rubbish. But here, he is surprised that anyone is there in this world who want to have rubbish. Who is Zam Bazar Jaggu? Why is he buying all this thing? You think he buys it for show? He sells it to a factory. Come on, I don't have time to waste like you. Now she told that he sell all this thing to a factory. And I don't have time to waste like you. You have to come fast. Velu did not move. He hadn't run away and come to this new place to dig through garbage bin. Jeff poked at him with her stick. Now children, poked means she jabbed him with the stick and she prompted him to come with her. Look here, she shouted. If someone gets there before us, we don't get anything. She told him, if somebody will get there before us, then that we will not get anything. Don't just stand there posing. Big hero, I'm trying to help you. Who filled your stomach today? And she told him, I'm that girl who is trying to help you, who filled your stomach today. Velu scratched his head and sighed. I will do it for now, he thought, until I had a better job. Now children, Velu was helpless. He did not have any work to do. So he told him, okay, I will do it for now. But till if I will get another better job, I will leave this job. Now children, some question and answer we will do. Page number 615. What material are the strange huts made of? The strange huts are made out of tin sheets, bricks, woods and plastic. Why does Velu find them strange? Velu find those huts strange because in his own village the huts were made of mud and palm leaves. Question number 2. What sort of thing did Jaya and children like her collect and what did they do with those things? Jaya and other children like her collected paper, plastic and glass. They sold all that to a kabadi or a junk seller. Velu is not at all happy. He had never done such a... children, is Velu happy or unhappy to find work? Give a reason for your answer. So Velu is not at all happy. He had never done such a work. He had never done such a dirty job according to him in his village. So children, we have done this lesson. We have discussed the question answer. And children, I will be discussing. I will be giving some more question answer. I will be missing. I will be giving you in the homework. And children, with this, I end my video here. Thank you and have a nice day ahead.